Good morning.
Good morning.
Peace be unto you and grace from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. I'll need y'all to pray for me this morning. I left my notebook at home, but I didn't leave just who it is that I serve. I ain't forgot about how good he is and where my faith lies at, because he is wonderful. So I know enough about him to get through this, but I ain't never trying to shortchange the people of God, so I just want y'all to, you know, be in prayer for a brother. But he is wonderful. Great job, choir. Oh man, what a blessed day it is to be in the house of the Lord. Just feel like praising him, you know? And everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. It don't take long when you start looking around and you start looking back over your life. Next thing you know, you done broke out into a song or something. I will sing praises. Praises unto you. I will sing praises. Praises unto you. I will sing praises. Praises unto you. I will sing praises. Praises unto you.
Being the example
of you forgiving us. And we want to follow in those footsteps. We don't want to hold malice and evil in our hearts. We need your spirit to fulfill these things, to be like you. But we can do it as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, dear Lord, but deliver us from evil. And we know that the only way for us to not to fulfill the lust of the flesh is to live and walk in the Spirit of God. And that we say thank you for. Thank you, Jesus, for being our way out. You always make a way out. Thank you for being our way out. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Threefold blessing in this quality of living. The first one is a material blessing. I pray that in every way you may succeed and prosper. This prosper means to become strong and flourishing. To cause to thrive. And that's what Maya Angelou always talked about. Living life and thriving. This prosperity caused you just to thrive from the goodness of God. See, he started this a long time ago, saints. He started with Abraham by faith. He blessed him. And look what it did. It did all these three things. And it covered his descendants all along for us. Now we children of the faith. Receiving in on this blessing. Oh, he did it with Aaron and that rod. If you start thinking about it, when it budded. You see what I'm saying? He didn't leave nothing out. He did it with Joshua and Caleb. He did it with Joel when he blessed his latter end more than his former saints. He said in Jeremiah 29, 11, I know the thoughts that I think toward you. Thus said the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you an expected end. I don't know about you, but that sounds like to me that in every way he wants me to succeed and prosper.
Yeah.
Stretch forth thy hand.
Right.
That sounds like some prospering to me.
Yeah, yeah.
See, the apostle here was praying this over Gaius, but in the days when I studied, the title of this said, this is God's will for all the saints.
Yeah.
For those who have faith, though, to receive this, because that's the foundation of it all, and there's a few principles that go with it, but you must have faith to receive this type of prosperity.
All right.
Pastor Thurman prayed this will wealth for the people. Same lines here.
Yeah.
But what was that you said the other week, Pastor, what the Lord told Peter? But I have prayed for you. Now that right there is trumping everything right there. Because that right there is for sure that this is going to come to pass right there. That our Lord has prayed for us. That our faith, do what? Fail not. Because that's the key to all of this right here. That our faith fails not. He got to talking about. Look at this right here. Prosper. Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. See, saints, it's better to be blessed than to be rich. And see, I'm going to get to what I'm talking about here, because all throughout the Bible, you see how hard it was for the rich man to enter into the kingdom. But see, this blessing of God, it's a whole another level, because richness becomes a part of it.
Yeah.
If you think I'm in Proverbs 10:22 says what, Reverend Holly? The blessings of the Lord make it rich and adds no sorrow to it. Now, this is something else. Peace and prosperity go hand in hand. The Lord said, like war and famine, my study said. Peace is automatically a part of prosperity. That's the, ain't no sorrow to it. You see, so this blessing of the Lord, see, anything you can do on your own, you better not be looking at that as a blessing. Because there's principles to the way the Lord gonna bless you. Give, and it shall be given to you. That's the Lord's blessing out of prosperity. And it's gonna always be in somebody else's hands to give it to you. But see, what you can do on your own, don't stand up and say, it's the Lord's blessing. You see, because I'm being leery of you if you're going to say that you believe that you blessed and you ain't got it by giving, you ain't got it by obedience and faith. And ain't that, you better watch out who's blessing you if you got it any other way than that way. Because the Lord going to honor his principles.
Yeah.
If you're faithful over a few things, I'm going to make you ruler over much. So he ain't going to go against that right there. People do stuff on their own all the time and say, the Lord bless me. What, did you get it by giving? Did you give it by obedience? Did you give it by faith? Well, the Lord answering all my prayers and you ain't giving? Well, guess what? He reigns on the just and the unjust because he's a good God. But that, this blessing right here with the